gonna be all Cinewhoop today, which is new for my channel. You guys are gonna unsubscribe if it's all Cinewhoop, aren't you? Will you still accept me if it's all Cinewhoop?
So I'm about 25 minutes out from the filming place. Just trying to get my head around what we're doing today because they said that the main objective of today is to get the horses used to the drones. Maybe start flying it in the distance and then get closer and closer. Hopefully they'll let me do that without people on the back of the horse. This is gonna be a strange experience, I can already tell.
Welcome to Wisconsin. And then over here is the liquor store I'll be going to later to get my new Glarus.
I wonder where I should park.
Hey, you old ducky.
Just walking right into my parking spot.
Sup, old boy.
Sure wish my 5-inch worked. Thanks a lot, Rush.
This is wild, man. So far, so good. Everyone is very nice. We made a plan about how the drone pilot is gonna stand by for a little while.
A long while.
And then with actors off of horses, we're gonna see which horses are bothered by the drones and which ones are not. Hopefully by the end of the day, they'll be more acclimated. They said that if anyone gets bucked off of a horse, that's what they signed up for. So hopefully it doesn't come to that, but hopefully I get it on film if it happens.
Almost charged back up.
Mike the man over here lent me a soldering iron to try and get my 5-inch quad working. Check out this soldering iron. Has anyone ever used one of these before to solder ESC pads? Hopefully I don't ruin the brand new Kiss.
You might want to trot up the helmet.
Are you gonna help me solder?
Don't do it, Harley.
Oh, watch out, watch out.
Harley, come here. Come lay down right here. Let him work.
No, Harley. This whole thing was born never knowing that in 2021 it was gonna be used for UAV tech. So the fun thing there is that I have a Kiss ESC in this drone and I have a Betaflight board. It's the Mamba F4 board. I couldn't for the life of me figure out how to program my ESC, so I couldn't reverse those two motors. So I had to do it the old fashioned way and switch their lines. She should fly now, but it's a toss up. Is the Cinewhoop so loud that it'll bother the horses? Or is it worth the risk to do a flight without any ducts? So risk hurting the horses or the riders, or spook them with a loud drone. It's a tough call, but I guess we're gonna get to the bottom of it today. Come with me, guys. I found the birthplace of a fresh new baby drone. Check this out. Let's try not to scare it.
Where are you, baby drone?
Look at that. Look at that. Oh. We won't go any closer because if you get close to a baby drone in its natural habitat, then its mother might not come back for it. Here comes the mother now. Yes, my number has been called. It's time to do drone exposure. It's probably not going to look super cool because at first it's just like a hover test to get the horses used to the sound. So the footage might not look great, but you'll get to see the process, which is cool. Ooh, I'm nervous. I don't want to cause any injuries, but they all said, you know, like, part of the game. I'm gonna fly the 5-inch first because it's quieter, and then we'll move to the cine. Shoot!
I've been giving the thumbs up, it's time to go. Fuck. Okay, here I come!
Badluck from the future. I wanted to narrate this first flight just to tell you how it felt to fly this drone towards a paddock of horses for the first time, not knowing if their reaction was to stampede away and drag their owners to the ground and, God forbid, injure somebody. Luckily, the woman in the middle with the black stallion, her name was Shannon, and she did a wonderful job organizing this, and we made a plan together before the drone ever went in the air and went over it a few times before we started. You can see that she just waved me over because she's decided that the horses are doing well enough that she thinks the drone can get closer. But I didn't see her because I'm on analog, so this is me sticking to the plan and going back and forth over by the street side. Now you can see that she's made the decision that the horses are doing well enough that she can walk over. That one white horse is particularly nervous and she is staying back, but the horses that are comfortable with it, she's walking them closer to the drone. You'll see down here, Shannon in the halter top there tries to wave me closer, and I didn't see her. So here's just some footage of me sticking to the plan. It's always best to have a plan, and I'm super grateful that she laid one out for me. That being said, sticking to the plan ended up luring all of the horses out into the road. I'm gonna fast forward past this sort of cringy bit where everyone ends up staying in the road and has to avoid a car because of me. Before I do that though, you can see in the bottom right hand corner that white horse that's running circles around her handler. That's a pretty good sign that that horse is not reacting well to a drone. There's Shannon looking up at me, wishing that I was taking cues from her. Now, in accordance to the plan, she told me that if the horses didn't seem bothered, that I could come down and fly with them. This is me sort of realizing that I've been down next to these horses this whole time, and as long as their handlers are with them and I'm not just hovering right in front of their faces, they're attentive, but they don't seem too bothered. So I start making some circles. You can see the stallion there, stomped a little hoof. The white horse is not having it. That one there is still cautiously looking at me, but is munching some grass, so it's casual. The handlers are doing a really great job of making sure that the horses are staying calm. My battery was dead, so I started to take it back in, and that's when it sort of started to sink in that, like, these majestic beasts were, like, accepting my drone, and that the rest of the day was gonna be smooth sailing flying around horses.
Let me get it.
I am Steve. There are many other Steves, but there is only one that is me. I am Steve. I could have been a David or a Gene, but then I wouldn't really be me. And I am Steve in the morning, Steve in the eve, Steve in the mirror looking back saying, who is me? I am Steve.
Okay, while this video is fading out, I have to talk about how disappointed I am about this shoot. I was under the impression that this was a rehearsal session for a short film that was going to be shot and had little to no plot, but was going to be a cool video of some medieval Game of Thrones combat shit. I was hired for zero pay, thinking that this was a not-for-profit operation and that everyone was volunteering their time, which for me worked fine because I wanted the shots for my demo reel and I liked the idea of having works with horses on my resume. I was doing it for the art and getting paid in experience points. But I was wrong. The director announced that he'd be charging admission to all quote-unquote cosplayers, so I messaged him and asked that because the terms have changed, if he planned on paying his camera people. To my surprise, he responded and said that I was the one who misunderstood, that I'd be paying admission, and that he would be charging the other camera people as well. So I pointed out to him that without the camera people present, he had nothing more than a LARPing event, and because of that, he should consider paying his camera people. He disagreed, so there will be no follow-up!
And to my camera people out there who are allowing the precedent to be set that we should pay people to show up to their events, shame on you. You're worth more than that. Camera work is an art form, a specialized skill, and it's work. Get paid, everyone. Know your worth. Peace out. Steve in the sea. Stevie looking for the meaning of Steve. Steve feeling lonely, but Steve ain't alone. There's a million other Steves in the little Steve homes. All singing. Run, Stevie, do what you can. Get your eyes.